Hi, I'm Joanna Jackson, and we're going to review mental health concepts. Let's start with a quick overview of our content. We'll talk about the importance of mental health education. I'll give you a few tips to how to remember this content. We'll define mental health and define mental illness. We'll review common signs and symptoms of many mental illnesses. We'll talk about nursing practice concepts, the DSM-5. We'll always review the nursing process. We'll talk about therapeutic communication, and finally, psychopharmacology. So why are mental health concepts so important for nurses? First, it's really important to know that patients in all areas and all specialties will be experiencing some amount of emotional distress and responses to that stress. It's important for the nurse to understand the basic concepts of mental health and mental illness to help you better care for your patients. At the heart of it, all nurses are psych nurses. Here's some quick ways to remember this content. Say the information out loud. Practice talking to your friends about it, or practice in the mirror. Practice as if you are the nurse explaining to a patient or teaching it to a class. Another quick way to help you remember this content is to make up funny or quirky acronyms about medications, processes, or whatever to help you remember the content. For an example, the nursing process, which is assess, diagnose, plan, implement, and evaluate, can be remembered as AD pie. If you visualize an apple pie with the letters AD on it, it will be really hard to forget AD pie, the nursing process. During the lesson, when you see these symbols, you'll know which part of the nursing process we're reviewing. Assessment, diagnosis, and planning, implementation, and evaluation. So what is mental health? It's the absence of any mental illness. It's a person exhibiting healthy coping mechanisms and responses to normal stress, and the person having the ability to fulfill responsibilities and relationships. It also includes adjusting and adapting to change. Now let's define mental illness. Mental illness is the maladaption to stress, exhibiting inappropriate thoughts, feelings, and behaviors, the inability to fulfill responsibilities and relationships, and any disorder that affects the behavior caused by the brain. Some common mental illness signs and symptoms include hallucinations, delusions, mania, excessive anxiety, and extreme mood changes. Some other signs and symptoms of mental illnesses include inappropriate affect. An example of that is a patient that receives really devastating or sad news and responds by laughing. That would be inappropriate affect. Rapid or pressured speech patterns, confusion, disorganized thoughts, altered orientation, that is not knowing the person, place, time, or their birth date, and sleep disturbances. While we're reviewing common mental health illnesses and their signs and symptoms, it's very important to be cautious. Perceived abnormal behavior does not indicate the presence of a mental illness. One's own personal and cultural beliefs may affect their behaviors and may not be mental illness. Mental illness can be highly subjective, so avoid judging and using labels. Now we will review the DSM. The DSM stands for Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders. Its first publication was in 1952, and we're currently on the 5th edition. This manual is specifically for mental health disorders. Let's review the rights of patients. All patients have the right to refuse treatment. All patients have the right to informed consent, which means the patient should be well aware of whatever procedure or medication that they are about to receive. All patients have the right to confidentiality. All patients have the right to receive visitors and telephone calls. All patients have the right to be treated with respect. And all patients have the right to the least restrictive environment. That means abstaining from seclusion or restraints when it is not necessary. Before you take the NCLEX, be sure to review theoretical models. Some of these include psychoanalytic theory, stages of personality development, theory of object relations, and theory of moral development. Some common therapies and treatments used in mental health include psychopharmacology, that is medications made specifically to help those suffering from mental health issues, electroconvulsive therapy, also known as ECT, cognitive therapy, behavioral therapy, and don't forget complementary therapies. This includes acupuncture, meditation, and massage. Now let's review common nursing diagnoses seen in mental health nursing. Post-trauma responses, anxiety, defensive coping, ineffective coping, fear, grieving, complicated grieving, or risk of grieving, ineffective denial, social isolation, risk for loneliness due to withdrawal, risk for suicide, self-mutilation or risk thereof, and risk for self-directed violence. Impaired religiosity or risk of spiritual distress, powerlessness, impaired resilience, or impaired mood regulation. It's the nurse's responsibility to maintain a safe environment. The environment is frequently referred to as the milieu, so milieu therapy is also very important. Promote self-care and education. Utilize the nursing process. Setting appropriate boundaries with your patients. Remaining non-judgmental. And avoid derogatory terms like crazy, insane, or any other institutionalized terms that could be offensive. Let's review a sample mental health nursing care plan. This one is risk for injury. The nursing care plan would read, risk for injury due to maladaptive and defensive mechanisms and resources related to substance abuse, anxiety, hallucinations, delusions, or any other behaviors that the patient may be exhibiting. Interventions for risk for injury could include assessing the client's level of orientation. That is, assessing if the patient is aware of who they are, where they are, and what time it is. Assess potential safety risks. Remove any and all objects the patient may be able to use to cause self-injury. Obtain drug history and use. And institute safety precautions on the unit. As with all nursing diagnoses, you always want to end with an evaluation. For risk for injury, be sure to evaluate that the patient is no longer showing risk for injury or evidence of injury. You should evaluate this not only by what the patient verbalizes, but their nonverbal communication as well. A major responsibility for nurses in any setting is to prioritize nursing interventions. In mental health nursing, safety is always the utmost importance. If given a question asking what nursing diagnosis is important while taking the NCLEX, the most immediate or life-threatening need should always be addressed first. Let's practice a question. A 23-year-old female with a history of depression is admitted into an inpatient psychiatric facility following a suicide attempt, immediately following a family member's death. The priority nursing diagnosis for this patient is A, impaired mood regulation, B, grieving, C, risk for injury, or D, ineffective denial. While all of these nursing diagnoses may be appropriate for this patient, risk for injury would be the most immediate need. Always address safety first. Also important for mental health nurses is therapeutic communication. This includes active listening. Be attentive to the patient. Show that you're listening by verbal and nonverbal behavior. Be empathetic. Always accept the other person's reality. Nurses should always encourage hope. Communicate to the patient that there's a possibility for improvement and/or recovery. And don't be uncomfortable or afraid of silence. This allows patients time to gather their thoughts and reflect on anything that they might be feeling or remembering. It's really important for mental health nurses to know what non-therapeutic communication is so that we may avoid it. An example of this is giving opinions. Be careful not to portray judgment or take away decision-making from the patient. Asking for explanations is also non-therapeutic. Asking a patient to explain what he or she believes can be perceived as an accusation or disbelief, and arguing. Even if you feel the patient is being dishonest, avoid exhibiting feelings of frustration or anger. If you must, remove yourself from the situation and return when you can contribute in a therapeutic way. Psychopharmacology is a huge part of mental health nursing. There are anti-anxiety agents, mood stabilizers, antipsychotic agents, antidepressants, sedatives, and hypnotics. Review indications, side effects, patient education, and normal responses to these medications before taking the NCLEX. Tips for success. When in doubt, always assess, diagnose, plan, and then implement. When given a question about what the nurse's priority is, always choose to assess before implement or taking any action. If two answers feel correct, and they frequently will, do your best to pick the most correct answer. And opposites attract. If two responses are worded fairly similar, but have something that's opposite in them, the correct answer is usually in one of those two. Good luck.